our kneeling bent reverse flies are a great strength move for the rear portion of the deltoid, so the back of the shoulder, as well as a little bit of the upper back. We're also gonna be engaging our core in this exercise because we are kneeling and hinged on over. So we're gonna be using those abs as well as those obliques and those spinal erectors, so those muscles in that low back, keeping that back nice and straight. Set up for this exercise, you're gonna grab two dumbbells. You're gonna want typically a little lighter weight on this one than you would for a standing bent reverse fly and even a seated bent reverse fly because you cannot generate quite as much momentum. There's not as much ability to cheat on this. And I'll show you just in a second, the hand positioning when we come down is gonna be slightly different. So come on down onto those knees, pick up those dumbbells. We're gonna hinge on over at the waist, pushing those hips back, making sure to keep that back nice and straight, not rounding over here. So push those hips back, get hinged on over. We're not upright, that's gonna be just a lateral raise. We wanna hit the rear portion of those shoulders. So push those hips back as you hinge on over. Weights are gonna be right on the outsides of my thighs here. I'm gonna get my head in line with that spine, core nice and tight. With a slight bend in those arms, I'm gonna come out nice and wide, squeeze those shoulder blades, and then control them right back down onto the outsides of those thighs. Remember, just like with a standing bent rear fly or a seated rear fly, we are leading with the elbows, so nice and wide. So from a front view here, it isn't a row, we're not coming like this. We are coming out nice and wide here. There's just a slight bend in the arms as I focus on those elbows pulling out and up throughout this movement. The other thing, like I talked about with that hand positioning, is gonna be a little bit different here, making this exercise a little bit tougher. Whereas on a standing fly and even a seated fly, those weights are coming all the way down together in front of the body here. Like this, this movement, they are coming down and stopping on the outsides of the thighs. And what that does is, it doesn't allow us to kind of swing from here to here. It doesn't allow us to generate that momentum to kind of swing those weights on up. They're on a dead stop here at our sides with no ability to kind of swing them out to get them going. So from that dead stop, you're having to go in to that rear fly, which is gonna make this one a little bit tougher, and you're gonna want a little bit lighter weights for these. So again, get in position here, hinge over, weights right on the outsides of those thighs, back staying nice and straight, nice and high up, and controlling it right back down to the outsides of those thighs, not in front of the body here. Biggest things to remember, like I just talked about, back is staying straight, we're staying hinged on over, those arms are staying fairly straight as we lead with those elbows, and those weights are coming down right on the outsides of the thighs, right on the outsides of the knees here, not in front of the body. So remember those four main things on this exercise. Keep that torso still and start with a light weight, get used to that movement, and then you can progress on up from there.